scale low. Welcome on in, everyone. I'm gonna start with some art with a stream, but I wanted to show off what I did for today's Inktober prompt first, because I know not all of you are in the community Discord to see that fun stuff. Or following me on VGen, where I also post it as soon as I'm done. At least until I'm out of showcase slots, because I'm not verified, so I don't have unlimited showcase, sadly. But yeah, today's prompt was Celestial, started with the kanji as always, but that first kanji is also used in Amatsuki's name, so I drew Amatsuki because I thought of him. Pets him very good. I'm also using Amatsuki as the BGM because I can. It was between him or a Milligram, because Milligram soon, which, yeah. So yeah, that's the BGM, Amatsuki. But also while we're here, might as well go over like all the other Inktober drawings I've done, right? And also the kanji. I was live when I did this little guy for the first prompt. I'm sure you guys remember. Or Sudomuro Gentaro. Fun times. They also drew this Kohaku for the second prompt live. I believe also Path. This was also on stream. This little not cobblestone texture. And then for a few of the days I just did the kanji and called it a day. It just be that way sometimes. And then Toad. The bunny for bounce. And of course, Kumaeda for fortune. I was gonna draw Monitor from Genshin for the prompt Wander, but I didn't like what I ended up drawing, so I ended up with just the kanji. The next one was Spicy. I wouldn't even really know what to draw that I would want to draw too. Like, obviously peppers, but yeah, I don't feel like drawing a pepper, so. Rise, just, I wouldn't really know what to do for Rise of all things. Castle, I just was out of ideas that day for sure. Because I'm sure if I really wanted to, I could easily have come up with something for Castle, but but I thought of something for Dagger, and I'm still really happy with this drawing. It's my PFP on, blah 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 blah, Discord. Night in the Moonlit Castle, isn't it Mansion, if you're referring to the Valkyrie song? Because if we're going OnStar songs, Castle of My Heart for Knights is what comes to mind. It's not Castle, it's Mansion. Hello Catman, welcome on in. I'm going over some of the things that I did for Inktober before working on other drawings. Angel drew Yuichiro, which makes a lot of sense in context of recent chapters. Yes, I know it's Mansion, why would I be wrong about that? How dare you doubt my information. To go with that though, naturally, Mika for Demon, even though, well, yeah, Demon. Why did I think it was Devil? I confused myself. Well, anyways. Saddle, yeah, just did the kanji for that one. Round Cat for Plump, definitely a top favorite. Very cute. Frost just... I'm sure if I really racked my brain, I could have come up with something for Frost, but I didn't want to. I'll be honest. Same thing with Chains. Scratchy, I couldn't even find a concise answer for, like, what it would be in Japanese. Maybe it's on Zaina. It also might not be. I don't know. I don't know if there's a Japanese equivalent for Scratchy. Castle Build of Sand. That might have been what you got mixed up on. Maybe. But yeah. And then today is Celestial with Amatsuki. I'm pretty happy with this one too. I feel like if I had to pick a favorite out of the drawings that I've done for Inktober, I'm torn between this and Vanitas, I'll be honest. As much as I love the cat too. Yeah. I've actually done a little bit of something for all the days though. I'm proud of myself. I haven't done that before. Granted, I made it easy for myself to just cop out with the kanji, but like, I don't know. I'm actually doing most of the prompts and I'm happy with that. Plump is number one. Well, someone is biased. Like, I love it too, but it's not my favorite. It's adorable, but you know. I'm not sure if I'm gonna draw anything for Shallow. I don't know, man. I can't really think of anything for Shallow, like, right now off the top of my head. But if you guys have ideas for Shallow, let me know. I feel like Dangerous will be too easy because that day also lines up with Mikoto's next Milgram song, so I probably gonna end up drawing Mikoto. Kawato on the Fountain? I'm not sure about that. That doesn't really fit Shallow in my opinion. Like, I guess the water is kind of shallow because it's a fountain, but eh. I actually have drawn Kanata for freaking Inktober before too. Granted, was it last year? Funnily, because last year I had OnStars prompts, but I did draw him before for Inktober. I hated the drawing that I did for that. He was so bad. I don't know if I'll do something for remove. We'll see how I'm feeling when we get to these prompts. But yeah, looks like I'll actually have a mostly full October. Like, even if ignoring the days where I had just kanji, like, this is a good amount of prompts that I've actually drawn something for. Remove, aka Yoink, thank you for your beautiful insight. Anyways, this is the drawing I'll be working on. Back to Shu, because his birthday is coming up really fast. Holy shit. I'm fine. Fuck, his birthday is actually really soon. Like, a week. I am a good way through this drawing, but fuck it. And then this bastard's birthday is shortly after, and he is... There's also a lot of stuff to do to finish him up. Oof. But I'm prioritizing Shu because his birthday is within the month still. Izumi is next month, even if it's the beginning of the month. Screaming. There is indeed too little October left, I agree. Ah. Yes, Shu. I have more details that I need to throw onto him. There's so many little details in this, but it's okay. Move things over so I can actually see them. You guys. Oop, didn't open up. There we go. But yeah, how are you guys doing? Raw. Fair enough, I guess. Are you looking forward to your interview tomorrow? The shoe is so nice though. Yeah, I think I'll be very comfortable to wear. I don't know, don't listen to me. Why did I just speak? That was a mistake, allowing me to speak. Little bit, but there's the novelty to being able to walk to your interview. Yeah, I mean, last time I had a job interview, I was able to walk to it. No, stay, Peachy. Why would you leave? So mean. Were you offended as a Shu cosplayer? Look, it's not my fault that you decided to cosplay a Shu. Offended is not the right word. Is it the French? I really shouldn't be allowed to speak. You want a plush shoe with cat ears? Interesting. Noted. I will not use that information for evil. Or will I? You may never know. You found one? No. Well. I almost dropped my pencil. That would have been so sad. Do you guys have any exciting Halloween plans you feel like talking about? Not really much of a just chatting stream if we're not just chatting, you know? Not sure if you like him. Interesting. Probably just streaming. You don't think you're doing anything? Do you know what you're gonna stream? We'll be streaming Day Of, I guess is another good question. If you're streaming Day Of, I won't be able to hop in, unfortunately. Maybe buy yourself a big ass bowl of chocolate. You know what? That's valid. Self-care, right? No, to have chocolate money, yeah. You don't know, whatever's on the poll is a possibility. Just a matter of if you finish other games or whatever, if that makes sense. Fair enough. Seems like there's currently a tie on that poll of yours. Hopefully others vote.
が今告げ口繋ぐ手と手もう当たり前だよねだけどそんな日々なくさないように抱き寄せるそばに君を形作るものは全て愛したいと思ったんだ 君の目に映る世界の続きを見たいと思ったんだ愛してるよマイラーマイラー腕の中でマイラーマイラー夢の中へダイバーダイバーまだ覚めないで愛してるよマイラーマイラーぼやけて見えないなクライアーもう気づいてるんだ
You got a stack to my cat fair. what do I have planned for Halloween? I do have class, so that's definitely gonna be the top plan. I might end up doing something with Peachy too, though. We haven't fully figured out details yet. Probably should do that sooner than later.
今はそれでも屁股の上の僕は情けないんだ。ギリギリ理由は少しギリギリになる理由はたくさんだけど代用品はないから腹をくりますかな。死んだ行くの先の自分を肯定するだけの覚悟ならもうできたから。ねえ浮気してねえ染みしてずっとずっと離れるようにねえさついてねえ色めいてずっとずっと離れるように最後の最後の最後にもう俺がいこっち向いてねえ嬉しい日もねえ楽しい日もずっとずっと離さぬようにねえ悩む日もねえやめる日もずっとずっと離れるように迷いなど捨てて抱き寄せてお願いそばにいて
お願いそばにいて
僕のこと見ててほしいのです最後の最後に愛し抜いていきたいと思うのねえ
ボン。稲妻に打たれました死にましたそして蘇りましたいたずらにその可憐さに一撃必殺で燃やされてる色めき出すライバルたちや席替えも委員決めも神なのにその根性で叩き直せよ裏向かってく戦国時代制してくは情報戦君の好きな音楽聴いてたどり着いた魔法陣君の心を打ち抜く今最前線落とせサンダー怒れワンダー僕ら快進撃を見せてやる届け君へ放ってランチャー恋心目標戦隊へスイッチサンダービーム街を行く君を見つけた運命これぞ主役の証明どんな風に登場しようあれその前にその男誰だ
我が太陽みたいな笑顔何を見せないような表情学校で見るよりずっとすげえちょっと大人に見えるけど腕まで組んで顔を近くて一体どういう関係性きっと弟もしくは姉じゃ親がディーダー親戚であれ
鳴らすオーラー倒すモンスター君を玉砕かす悪い奴らを消し去るから分かってんだ悪あがきのサンダー本当に撃ってたらいいのにな
君の悲鳴聞こえたらエマージェンシー走るぞ
走るぞ
ガチの悪い奴相手にできるんかビビり散らすだけどファイター僕の友達は愛と勇気だけ落としサンダーなぜかダスター しい風吹く青空の匂い、今日はだらっと過ごしてみようか。風鈴が散りうひまわりの黄色、私には関係ないと思っていたんだ。夏が始まる、
Hello, how's it going? Welcome on in. No, thank you for your contribution to the goal. Thank you for your contribution as well, Spooky. How long is the goal up for? Let me double check. 16 days left. Though I might put an extension on it. We'll see how I'm feeling. You gonna try blind typing? Good luck. Welcome back to life, Peachy. I'm not getting the shape right. So spelling will be wonky, fair enough. Sicky hours. Ruby for water, okay. How were you? I mean, you got a P instead of an O, so close. No, my day? My day hasn't been too bad so far. Been pretty productive, actually. Baked some bread. Who needs candles when you can just bake some bread? And then I've also made some cookies as well. Just box, though, not from scratch. You have to type so slow, it's annoying. Aww. Blind, you mean not looking at the keyboard? I kind of figured that's what you meant. No worries. You lost me on that one. You definitely lost me on that one, sorry. Or for fun. Oh, okay. This current drawing is not a commission. It is, I guess you could say, for fun. I basically have a little challenge with myself for, like, a group of characters to draw them at least in time for their birthday, and I can have an art print up on my store before it. So no one's like paying me directly for it, but if anyone decides to buy the print, it pays for itself, sort of thing. So. I think now is a good time to start reading some Am I the Asshole posts, though. I think I've given people enough time to join if they wanted to join, sort of thing. Let me adjust things, though. Yo. Bloop, bloop, bloop. Bloop. In case I feel like still poking at it. We'll see though. I'm a little done. It's a little hard to read, isn't it? I don't really want to go down. It's okay, I'll be reading. It's okay, don't worry about it. Okay, let's see. Let's refresh the page, see if there's anything new. Nope, okay. Well, I might as well read this one that's right here. I don't know. None of you guys sent any, like, Am I the Asshole posts to read in the Discord, so... it's kind of doing whatever. Let's see, though. Oh boy. Am I the asshole for going through my friend's closet to find my wedding dress? Oh boy. That's a strong start. Let's see. 2 years ago, my husband and I were doing some renovations to our house. I didn't want my wedding dress to get damaged or lost in the process. Fair. Which, considering we did lose a few things during the renovation, I was right to be concerned. My friend offered to keep it in her closet until the renovations were done. Alright. After we finished the renovations, I asked my friend for the dress back. She kept saying she'd get back to me. I kept asking and she'd make up excuses. I found it weird. That does sound weird. I think I know what you're trying to say. I made a little channel in my community Discord for people to have shared Am I the Asshole posts for me to read tonight. No one shared anything though, so it's just kind of an empty channel. It didn't say anything about anyone joining anything though. Just reading this Reddit post. Let's see. Right. Friend kept making up excuses, has wedding dress for renovations, got it. Now my sister is getting married and she wanted to wear the dress. That's cute. This was our mother's dress and we always agreed we'd wear it. That's cute. I told my friend I need it back. She claimed she couldn't find it? Then what was the point of you even being the one to take care of it? I was perplexed because how does it just get up and walk away? Yeah. She apologized and offered to pay me the cost of the dress, which I turned down because it wasn't about money. The dress was sentimental and I felt terrible my sister couldn't wear it. You have cookie, can't type. Oh boy. My friend and her husband went away. I was there to water their plants and feed their dogs. I decided to go look myself. The closet was very cluttered. I eventually found the dress. I can totally believe that she missed where it was and she wasn't being malicious in the slightest. The box was tucked behind a few larger ones containing seasonal clothes. I texted her saying I found the dress. Instead of being happy for me, she asked why I rummaged through her closet. I said I just wanted to double check. She told me I had no right to go through her things. I said that because of her clutter, my sister almost didn't get a weird dress she always dreamed of. My friend told me I could have asked her to look again, but pointed out it took 2 years for her to even look in the first place. Am I the asshole? I'm gonna go with no, because... Yikes. Maybe stop being friends with said friend, though. I would have just taken it and never told her, let her think she lost her mind. Yeah, that's fair. I don't even think she would have attempted to find a gun. Probably not. Well, so interesting that she knew exactly where you rubbish to find this lost dress. Yeah, that's also interesting. OP, I mean this in the nicest way, but you're being naive. She was trying to keep your dress, simple as that. If all you had to do was go through the closet in her house, it wasn't lost or misplaced. It was exactly where she put it, and she knew that. Yeah. Was your friend over during the renovations? You might need a second chance to rummage at her home before she returns. Oof. Did OP reply to that? Doesn't look like it. But yeah, that's... I think she's overwhelmed by her own clutter, hence not going in and digging it out for 2 years. And hello, YouTube's rude. Yes, keep watching. And being embarrassed it's out in the open, which would be why she's mad at OP for rummaging. Very understandable, but still not fucking cool, especially for something so valuable. By very understandable, I mean I logically understand how friend could have this other reason for not giving their dress back and being mad at OP, not think I, that I think it would be right. Yeah, that's fair. Yeah, no, I think the friend might have been trying to keep the dress because, as the other person pointed out, they knew exactly where it was when you said that you found it, so... Yeah, I don't know, man. Thanks. Well. Well, that's the most recent post as far as I'm aware. Oh, this one seems to be more new and seems more juicy. Oh boy. Oh, this is, ooh, okay, okay. This one seems to be more juicy. Let's see what happens, I guess. Am I the asshole for snapping at my sister-in-law after she accused me of trying to replace my kid's father? What cereal goes best with ice cream? It really depends on the ice cream, I would say. But I personally wouldn't pair cereal with ice cream, so I'm afraid I can't give an answer. Okay. I, 33 female, became widowed when I was just 29. Oh boy. In my opinion, I don't have one. I wouldn't pair cereal with ice cream. I spent 9 wonderful years with my husband, John, and we were happily married for more than 6 of those years. We welcomed our first daughter, I can read, Ellie, 11 female, and he was a doting father to her. His death was so unexpected and sudden, as he was only 32 and it broke me and Ellie, which is understandable. It was even sadder because we had found out not long before he died that I was pregnant with Sophie, 3 female, and he never got to meet her. That is sad. I spent the past 4 plus years being on my own. All my attention went to Ellie to help cope with losing her dad and to provide as best a life I could for her and my then unborn child as a single mom. I convinced myself I was content with being fulfilled by motherhood and watching the two people I love more than anything grow and be happy, but it's been incredibly lonely. I have missed company and companionship or even just having someone to talk to, so I decided to put myself back out there. Fair. I joined a dating site around 2 to 3 months ago, and I really hit it off with Danny after being on there after a couple of weeks. 35 male, fair enough. We've been on several dates and have been talking a lot. I know it's early days, but it honestly feels refreshing just having someone to talk to about my day or about me, as I spent so long just forgetting about me for the sake of my kids. And it's nice that someone wants to know me. It's like I have opened up a part of myself and allowed myself to be happy after so long. I loved my husband very much and have missed him terribly, but I know he's never coming back. I mean, he is dead, so, I think 4 years is a long time to spend on your own, and I think even I have left it long enough that it's okay to meet someone else. I mean, everyone heals at their own pace, but I was really excited, so I decided to tell my sister-in-law, my late husband's sister. She's very close to my nieces and helped me a lot when John died. I told her that I have met someone who is going well, he is very nice, I feel happy around him, and that I hope it progresses eventually. She didn't take the news well and actually got really angry and said that I'm moving on too quickly and that I'm trying to replace John. It's been 4 years. I got really angry myself when I snapped. I asked her how long she expected me to be on my own. 5 years? 10? Until the kids are grown? I told her I spent 4 years mourning and that she had some nerve to insinuate my husband's death meant nothing to me, and that I'm going to let some random man enter my child's lives, which isn't happening at all. He hasn't met my kids, and he isn't going to anytime soon, if at all, depending on how well things go with us. Plus, I am not looking for someone to replace John or someone to become a dad to my children. I just miss romance, that's all. And that is fair. I haven't really spoken to her since, as her comments have left me furious. She has sent me messages saying she is sorry I took her words the wrong way, but that she is just looking out for me and the kids, but I think it's BS. I've been discussing this with a friend of mine and asked for her opinion. She thinks I have sacrificed a lot over the last few years and I'm allowed to move on with my life. She also says my sister-in-law is completely out of line and was deeply insensitive, especially since my husband's death completely broke me and it was like my whole world was different for me. Yeah, definitely not that asshole. Like, it really isn't the sister-in-law's place to be like, oh, you're moving on too fast. Everyone heals at their own timeline, like, bleh. Yeah, everyone grieves differently, but 4 years seems like a socially appropriate amount of time for you to have put off dating. Maybe your sister-in-law just wasn't the right person to share your news with in hindsight. Yeah. Well. Yeah, I don't know. So in other words, she didn't apologize. Yeah, that is true. Yeah, okay, well that's that one. Service dog into party. I guess locked post in only 11 hours. I'm intrigued. I, 29, male, hosted a pumpkin carving party for my friends, and I this past weekend, and a decision I made is causing drama amongst us. The party was indoors, as it's nearly 100 during the day where I'm at. I dislike cats and dogs any and all. My friends know this. Well, aren't you a delight? Primarily, I think they're filthy. Well, aren't you a delight? I want nothing to do with them because of that. My buddy and his current fling, early relationship girlfriend, however you want to define it, showed up. She has a golden retriever with her. I did not know this dog was coming. No one ran this by me, I would have said no. We pulled him aside and told him the dog had to go. He says that the dog has to go, she has to go, and then I have to go too. I just say, come on man, you should know better than to bring a dog to my house. He said that it's a service animal, apparently for diabetes. He thought it would be different. I said no, it might medically help her, but it's still a fucking animal. Okay, but it medically helps her. Would you tell her to keep her cane at home? I don't know, dude. It starts arguing but maintained my stance. I offered to keep it in the garage with the AC on, and how is the dog supposed to do a medical alert if needed? He goes and talks to his girl and she looks annoyed. I felt bad about that. They offered to leave. Lets me know I'm an asshole. My friends were all split on how I handled it. Am I the asshole? Yes. The dog is a medical device in this case, buddy. Everyone sucks here. I'm a service dog handler and I think everyone handled the situation poorly. You're not the wrong for not wanting a dog in your private dwelling. It's your right not to allow even a service dog in your private home. Yeah, that's fair. However, I think the way you handled the situation was poor. Sounds like you're not very understanding of the shitty position that you put your friend and his girlfriend in and the way your actions probably made them feel. Like I said, you have every right to make the decision to not allow whatever medical equipment you want in your house, but if you choose to make that decision, you need to understand that there are effects on the person whose medical equipment you're banning. When you choose to exclude someone like that, especially on the basis of a disability that they can't control, it's understandably going to be hurtful to the person you're excluding as well as their loved ones. And you should have approached this situation with a lot of tact, empathy, and sincerity. Based on your post, it doesn't sound like you approached the situation with any of those things and that you expect them to be cool with the way you treated them, which is unreasonable. I also think your friend and his girlfriend handled the situation poorly. I can tell you that I would never, ever show up at someone's private home with my service dog without clearing it with the person first. Yeah, that's fair. Like I said, the homeowner has every right to not allow my dog there, and sometimes there's even very good reason for that, like someone at home having a dog allergy or a fear of dogs. And even if the person just goes, "I don't like dogs and therefore don't want you here," that's their right, so always check first and respect the homeowner's decision. The friend of the girlfriend absolutely should have spoken with you about this first. However, they're not assholes for being upset. You told them, "I dislike your dogs is more important to me than spending time with you and more important to me than your physical safety." Yeah. While you have every right to feel that way, they also have every right to be upset by that. You can't expect that person will not have a negative reaction when you choose to treat them that way, and they're not assholes for responding negatively. They thought you were their friend and found out that you're not, or at least not a very good one, and they were disinvited from a party in front of an audience because their girlfriend has a disability, which is a super shitty thing to go through. So yeah, they're going to be upset with you about it, and I don't think they're in the wrong for feeling that way. You both made mistakes. They should have asked you ahead of time about the dog, and you should have treated them with more empathy when telling them they had to leave, and also be more understanding of the fact that you're making a decision that's hurtful to others is going to have consequences. Yeah. Well, I don't really have much else to add to that one. I understand why the post got locked, though. Is there anything that sounds interesting?
Ooh.
Oh boy, am I the asshole for telling my 20-year-old female fiance, 24 male, that he needs to stop ridiculing my degree? Poo mode activated. What does that mean? Well, whatever. Let's get into this, I guess. Hi, everybody. Ominous face. My 20 female and my fiance 24 male will get married next year in the summer, and I'm very much looking forward to this. We have our issues, but then again, which couples don't, right? However, lately, he has been ridiculing my studies and the degree I'm getting. I'm studying in the Netherlands and he lives in Denmark, so we will close the distance next year after the wedding. I'm currently in my last year of the bachelor's degree in biomedical sciences. I would argue, but of course I'm biased, that this is a very intensive study and requires a lot of time and effort. The title makes it sound like she's blameless and I'm predicting shenanigans. Yeah, I'm also predicting shenanigans. But biomedical sciences, that definitely would be intensive study in my opinion too, and I'm not biased, so... Sometimes when I complain about this, he says that my degree doesn't matter and that I'd be better off quitting anyway. The reason he says this is because we would like to have a marriage with more traditional gender roles once we're married. See, he will earn the money and will become a stay-at-home mom. Can you turn down the music a bit? Yeah, I can. But interesting. But she doesn't have a problem with that, so... But I would like to have a degree to fall back on during tough times. Whenever I try to make this argument, he shuts it down immediately and claims that I would be better off just quitting my studies and becoming a housewife already, since once we're married, I will never use my degree anyway. I would not mind working 2 times a week, but he strongly opposed to this as he claims it would interfere with my tasks and chores in our marriage. 2 days a week of work will not interfere with chores unless he's an absolute pig. He's currently still in carpentry school, which consists of him having several months of work followed by weeks of school, both of which he gets paid for. Fair. That's cool, actually. Not only does he dismiss the difficulty of my degree, but he also claims that the work he is doing is much harder. I mean, it's definitely more physically demanding, but I can't disagree with him because physically speaking, it is definitely much more intensive, but I would like for him to acknowledge that my degree is also time-consuming and difficult. Recently, he made a joke about what a waste of time it was, me getting my degree when I should be in DK, and making him dinner instead. Jesus Christ, go back to home and have your mom do it for you. Since that would be more fulfilling for both him and me. Would it? I know I should not let these harmless jokes get under my skin, I'm not sure it's a joke. But I lashed out at him and told him he needed to stop ridiculing my academic achievements and dismissing all of it so easily, since it might come in handy at some point in the future. He then quite seriously told me, again, that I shouldn't take everything so personally and that he was speaking the truth, since I'll not use my degree once we are married, so it's a waste of time and money. Divorce him, yeah, you're not even married yet, but divorce him. Then somehow he spun it around and told me I was not appreciative enough of him wanting to provide for me and our future family, and that if I wanted to be a girl boss, I would be free to do so on my own. Buddy. So now I'm wondering if I did make a mistake by telling him to stop ridiculing my degree, and if I somehow hurt him by appearing ungrateful. So am I the asshole? No, it seems like you're about to marry an abusive man. No, you are making a mistake by planning to marry someone that doesn't respect you. Yeah. He won't let you use your worthless degree even for a part-time job. He will mentally wear you down to nothing. You're the asshole to yourself. Yeah. He has told you what life being married to him will be like. Believe him. Yeah. It's major yikes. Well, this post has Poo mode mod activated. When this post is in Poo mode, only users with enough Am I the Asshole subreddit comment karma are able to comment. Okay. I was wondering about that. Run, yeah. I made a similar mistake. My husband was so dismissive of my degree, and as we got farther in our careers, further, I became the breadwinner, and he was so negative that the day I got my diploma, he threw a tantrum about having to go to my graduation in front of our kid, mind you. Yikes. If he doesn't respect you now, he won't after you're married. Yeah. Is this post real? Are you sure you're from Netherlands and Denmark? Because those are countries where gender roles as parents have been pretty much equalized a long time ago. You have both parents and a credible amount of parental leave. I know Netherlands is almost a year, that's cool. They have an amazing support system for working parents in place, so everybody can stay home with the babe the first year and then go back to work with so much flexibility. Yeah, that's cool, but yeah, that said, not the asshole, drop the man before you get married. Stay at home, mom, nothing wrong, but you have to be on board with it, so pushed into it. Also, if he gets married at 21 in Europe, I don't know. But yeah, that's... Jesus Christ, please don't marry this man. I think that's definitely the big consensus here. Jesus. Sorry, what? Am I the asshole for refusing to go out to dinner with my autistic nephew because of ranch dressing? What? They've been deemed not the asshole, so I'm intrigued. Even further, rather. My 27 female have my cousin, 34 female, my nephew, 10 male, and niece, 6 female, coming to stay with me for 4 days next month. My nephew is autistic and has some food troubles. In some ways, he's not a picky eater, he eats a very balanced diet, and is willing to try most things if he's given ample time to mentally prepare. Understandable. What? Hello, Peachy. Welcome back. That being said, he won't eat anything with that ranch dressing. Oh, he's one of those. He puts it on everything, including sushi and soups. Oh, God. If it does not have ranch, he won't touch it and has a full-blown meltdown if you try to force him. I mean, autism, go brr. He keeps a little thermos with ranch on him anywhere he goes just in case. You know, if that makes him happy, enjoy that thermos of ranch, I guess. My sister really wants to go and have some foods she has been missing, such as Thai and Indian. The shoe is so beautiful, thank you. I think that's great, but I know these restaurants don't serve ranch. I called around to the restaurants to see if they would allow me to bring outside ranch into the restaurant due to my nephew's disability, but they said they can't make any exceptions for outside food. Beautiful. Thanks. You're all for a creamy soup, but ranch? I won't yuck his yum, but I will yum ask why. Oh dear. I will yuck his yum. Like, I won't stop him, but you. But yeah, I told my cousin as such, and she insisted we could just sneak some ranch into the restaurants, it'll be fine, since she apparently does it all the time at home. I refused. I feel really uncomfortable with the idea, I like these restaurants, and don't want to risk getting banned. I know we can just order takeout, and both the kids prefer to stay at my place anyway. I told my sister if she was that insistent... Ugh. I told my sister if she was that insistent on going out to eat, I could watch the kids while she went out, or stay at home with just my nephew, and she could enjoy the meal herself. My cousin was horribly offended by the suggestion and has been blowing up my phone saying I'm an asshole, trying to prevent her from having a nice vacation with her kids, and that I'm ableist despite being autistic myself. Oh, oof. Okay, but Opie is clearly doing the most because they called the restaurants ahead of time. Like, that's going an extra mile for real, for real. Yeah, like, not only did they call the restaurants ahead of time, but they also offered, like, yeah, I can just stay at home and you can enjoy that. But otherwise, like, this isn't going to work out because the restaurants have expressly said, hey, you can't do that. Like, I don't really think I'm being an asshole, but I'm really bad at understanding social norms, and now her husband and my aunt are texting me saying I'm horrible for suggesting she can't have dinner out with her children. It's not that she can't go out and have dinner with her children, it's that she can't go out and have Thai and Indian at these specific restaurants because they said they can't bring the ranch. Like, she's been threatening me not to come visit me. I just go stay with her parents who live 2 hours away in the opposite direction. Say, am I the asshole? Edit. Wow, I did not expect so many people to have an opinion on this. Thank you for the comments, even the people saying I'm an asshole. I'm slowly getting through all the comments. To answer a couple of things that keep coming up. One, I want it to be accurate for the story, so I called her my cousin. She is my cousin, technically. But she's basically my sister, and I call her as such, what we call each other. And my tired brain didn't filter that properly. Fair enough. Two, my nephew was working with a professional to help expand his food preferences and ability to eat food without ranch. There's been a small amount of success, but the main way there's been any success is by planning with him what he wants to try weeks in advance. He now eats rice and white bread occasionally without it. Let's go. I'm basically putting the food on the table and giving him as long as he needs to try it. This includes letting him leave the table to have a least in. And likes running around in circles before he tries it, and does not always work. But they're trying, so that's cool. 3. In regards to why my nephew eats everything with ranch, it's a flavor thing. His man should express this to us. We have been experimenting to try and figure out why that flavor is okay, but most other flavors aren't. There hasn't been a lot of success yet. 4. A lot of people are saying I'm an asshole, or saying that I'm being irrational about getting in trouble with these restaurants, and maybe that's fair. Part of my autism is that I'm extremely rule-breaking avoidant. Like, obviously some rules have to be broken in life or death situations, but something like bringing ranch into a restaurant when I've been told no does not feel life or death, and I'm at risk of struggling and having a meltdown myself if I sneak ranch into the restaurant after explicitly being told no. One of the few things I still really struggle with. Not to mention some of these restaurants, for me personally, are safe spaces where I know I can eat most of the menu and it doesn't trigger me in any way, so I feel like I'd be putting that at risk. Yeah, that's fair. It's not worth bringing in ranch to risk possibly being told, hey, you can't come back because you've smuggled in ranch. As ridiculous of a situation that is. I'm going to talk with my cousin with my nephew on the phone and see if we can all come up with something together. The suggestion about letting him eat before and then just get a drink at the restaurant might work. And one of the restaurants is next to a gelato place that I know he can pour ranch over without them caring. Ranch on gelato? Whatever. And also, this isn't some discrete amount of ranch. If you can see the food, it's not enough ranch. If it was a discrete amount, I might be more comfortable. Oh boy, autism go burr sometimes, for real, for real. But yeah, I definitely do agree with the consensus that they're not the asshole. Like, they've gone above and beyond to make things work out for their nephew. But, ugh. I've worked in restaurants on and off for years, and it's all about cross-contamination. Yeah, that too. The fact that you offered to babysit as well so she could enjoy the food without stress was kind of you. Yeah, it sucks that the world doesn't cater to us, so neurodivergent, but you did your research, gave alternatives, and attempted to find a way to suit everyone. Sounds like she's throwing a tantrum from not getting her own way. But is there also a chance this is burnout mom projecting her frustrations due to being desperate for a bit of normalcy? Maybe. Also, the world ableist is getting excessively thrown around today, so try not to let this wear you down. Edit for people replying to my comment. There have been several valid reasons below provided by other Redditors as to why it's considered cross-contamination. I didn't make up the rule, but unfortunately it is one that both employees and customers are expected to follow. Yeah. OP's suggestion is truly the best though, like, yeah. She's quite burned out, husband works abroad and has been gone for almost the last 4 months. Part of the reason for this trip was so she could get a bit of a break. I work in childcare, specifically with children with disabilities, so giving her time to relax was sort of my plan. I see. My aunt, however, is absolutely mental, part of the reason my cousin moved away. And while my cousin is normally level-headed, I worry that the stress of essentially being a single parent, my aunt has been influencing her in the wrong way. Aww. But yeah, not the asshole, oh my god, just get takeout. Enjoy a lovely ranched-out restaurant meal with the family at home. Yeah. But you know, we got it. I'm still a little perplexed about the idea of that much ranch on everything. And just ranch on everything. But you know, the nephew's living his best life, I guess, with everything smothered in ranch, right? I don't know. I'm also intrigued by this one. Am I also for accepting an invite to a vacation that did not include my husband? My sister and mother planned a girls' trip, DW, vacation for them, myself, and my daughter, 8. My sister and mother are paying for everything. My husband was not included in their plans, neither of the husbands will be attending. I have not been on a plane in over 20 years, nor on any kind of big resort vacation like this since I was a child. Our daughter has also never been on a plane or to Disney. Disneyland. I have also never been to Disney. Despite living really close to it now, I still have not been to Disney. Outside of downtown Disney, but that barely counts. Yes. My husband had previously expressed to my mother that he does not like Disney. He told me he would not be able to get off work. He told me we could not afford it. He said he would not enjoy being there with my sister and mom and would just be a crab ass anyways. Okay, then he could be a crab ass at home. When they first invited me and I happily accepted, he and I got into a huge fight. My husband eventually offered to pay for him and add him to the trip. Or even to buy a plane ticket for a day, so he can come one day and see our daughter at Disney. He declined the invite for the same aforementioned reasons. And yet, he still is set upset. I can't bring it up without him blowing up. I get that he's jealous, but if the shoe was on the other foot, and his dad had planned a guy's trip with the kids, I would be supportive. The trip is next week and I'm feeling very guilty because I was getting excited/planning outfits, packing and whatnot. asked me to not even talk about it so he can pretend it's not happening. I feel like I should just cancel and not go. Am I the asshole for accepting an invite to a trip without him? No. He can just go be a crab ass on his own and honestly don't come home. Leave his ass. Like, if it's like this over just a trip, it's probably like this over a lot of other things. He could die mad about it. Yeah, for real. Bro, if he doesn't like Disney, why would he want to go? Yeah, I don't know, man. Not the asshole. If the husband expressed before the trip was planned, he does not like Disney, he would not be able to get off work. We could not afford it. He would not enjoy being there with my sister or mom, would just be a crap ass anyways. Mother-in-law offers to pay his way, and he still declines. I don't see anything wrong with OP going, but I can't help but wonder if her husband is grumpy about something else. I don't think this is about their Iranian yogurt. Maybe. Dad needs to huff some copium, so true. I mean, it seems like it's gonna be a crab ass either way. I'd rather he be a crab ass at home rather than ruining the experience for the kid. Seconding the not the asshole. Yeah. Not the asshole, your husband wasn't invited on this trip because it was a girl's trip and he's not a girl. Also, he sounds super exhausting and childish. I hope he brings a whole lot to the marriage. A whole lot. Please go with your mom and sister and daughter, you know, your girls, and have a blast. I think you have something to think about after you get home. Yeah. Totally one of those that leaves me thinking, if she's willing to put up with all this, the dude's gotta have a magic dick. I mean, maybe. Maybe he could detach it or something, who knows. Just confirming you only have the one child, right? If that's the case, do not cancel the trip. Tell him that if you cancel the trip, you have to explain to his daughter that they were going to Disney to see Mickey and the princesses, but Daddy got mad and said they couldn't go. Not the asshole, but your husband needs to grow up. Yeah. Yep, just the one at home still. Oldest is out of the house and very much over Disney. Fair. What's the quote from the dinosaur sitcom? Our marriage license expired and renewing it cost $40. I thought about it and realized it wasn't worth $40. Jesus. That's an iconic quote, but I don't know what that's a reference to, unfortunately. Your husband is a baby. Go on the trip, have fun, but do not let him ruin things while you're there. He'll send rude messages, complain that things are falling apart at home, and then he's having an awful day. Basically try to guilt you and ruin every day for you while you're gone, not the asshole. Yeah. Oof. Rude babies don't get to go to Disney. Yeah, that's wild, man. I hope that they go on the trip and say fuck you to the dad, because, yeah. Okay, I'm a little concerned about this one. Am I the asshole for refusing to plan my son's birthday party because of how my ex behaved when I planned our daughter's? I have two children with my ex. Our daughter's fifth birthday was the first birthday we weren't together, so we came to the agreement that I would plan everything and he would pay for it. Fair enough. He said I could spend as much money as I wanted, and since our daughter was taking the breakup badly, I wanted to go all out for her special day. Fair enough. Despite acting like he wanted no part in the planning, he was an absolute nightmare. I mean, I guess he's an ex for a reason. I had his credit card, and he originally said he didn't need me to tell him everything I was spending money on, but then he suddenly started being nasty about it. I guess he's an ex for a reason. He kept demanding I tell him everything I'd booked and would criticize every little thing. I didn't care about him wanting to input into the party, but the way he was speaking to me made me feel dirty for needing to have him pay for everything. I only sucked it up because our daughter knew about some of the things I had arranged for her already, which I would have had to cancel if I started fighting with him. Now our son's second birthday is next month, and my ex has once again suggested I plan the party and he'll pay for it. I refuse because I'm not going to let him make me feel the way he did while I planned our daughter's again. That's fair. I told him he would need to plan the party and that I wanted no part in it. He has apologized for how he behaved and claims he'd never do it again. Granted, he has been a lot nicer to me recently, but I'm still not comfortable putting myself in that position again. That's fair. Since I won't plan the party, his making up bullshit claims that I favor our daughter over our son. Milsa said that if I don't plan a party, our son wouldn't have one since he's too busy to plan it, but he could always ask his mother for help. I feel like, I don't know, I would suggest, if I were talking to OP directly, that they still plan something for their son, but just don't have the father have anything to do with it. Like, it could be something simple, like, just plan at least a cake or something with a few people or something. Still something at all, you know? Just, I don't know. Don't use your children as bargaining chips in an argument with your spouse. Yeah. Yeah, it's your son's second birthday. Have a cake and celebrate at home. Your son isn't gonna remember any of this. But make sure to take pictures of him and the cake so you can show him when he's older. Yeah. Or, OP, tell your ex you'll do separate parties moving forward. The kid could have two. Yes. You do what you want to do, and then when they go with their dad, he can plan what he wants. In the event of a peaceful divorce between two people want the kids to come first, it makes sense to do joint parties. In the event of a divorce of someone who treats you like garbage, you don't need to celebrate anything with him. You can be polite at pickups and drop-offs. You can communicate when it comes to important things with the kids. Otherwise, that's it. Yeah. He's your ex for a reason. Why are you participating in this argument? Just plan a small party and pay for it. Solve your problem. Your son is too. He won't remember everyone sucks here. Yeah. I agree. You absolutely do not include your ex anymore. It's a perk of splitting up. Freedom. Have your own party and do not invite him. You're new to this, but I can assure you this is how it goes. Yeah. Yeah, separate parties is definitely the way to go. Poor children. Hopefully things get better. Oof. Okay. Am I the asshole for pulling out math problems to prove my cousin is not smarter than me? We're both seniors in high school. You definitely sound like a high schooler. And live in different states. My family went to her state for a wedding, which is when this whole thing blew up. At the wedding, her parents were bragging to everyone that she's in the top 10 of her class. This didn't bother me until they started asking the cousins who are high school age what their rank is. That's not normally kept track of. I was very annoyed at this because I'm in the middle of my class. Why do you know this? But I go to one of the top high schools in my state. It's so good that it's well known that the top 10 usually go to Ivy League schools. Alright. Anyway, I tried to ignore them, but eventually her father came to our table to talk to my parents. Of course, he brought up her top 10 standings and then turned to me and asked mine. I answered that I didn't know, which made him laugh, and told me that he bet it's not top 25%, or else I would know. I was about to say something, but my mom pinched my thigh hard to where I had to look at her. The entire thing put me in a bad mood for the rest of the night. That's fair, but... When we got back to our hotel, I spent the night looking up her high school and found a bunch of articles about how bad her school district is. I found an article that stated fewer than 10 students her entire school were proficient at math. I laughed hard, save those articles, then went to sleep. You were definitely being a high schooler about it. Do people care this much about high school class placements? Hey, hold on, I bet these are rich people. I bet they're rich people, too. The next day at family dinner, almost everyone was there when her parents started up with it again. I pulled up some samples I pulled up some example SAT math questions and challenged her to complete them. The short of it is, she didn't get any right. Her parents yelled at my parents yelled at me, and dinner was ruined. I mean, you were a high schooler being a high schooler about a high school problem, so... She later texted in her cousin's group chat that I'm an ass for putting her on the spot, and I replied that it's easy being in the top 10 when everyone else is an idiot. I mean... That makes you think of some bullshit you do during middle or high school if you were self-conscious about something, to be honest. I can't think of anything specific, but so far it sounds like the kid has something to prove or whatever. Yeah. We're home now, and my parents want me to smooth things over by apologizing to the rest of the family, and specifically to my cousin for putting her on the spot. I don't want to, but Dad told me that Grandpa's gonna ban us from Christmas gathering unless I do. I really don't want to. Okay, well, you are a high schooler. But at least apologize to the cousin, because, like, the main issue is with the cousin's parents, not the cousin, you know? But I digress. Everyone sucks here except for your cousin. Yeah. It was her parents bragging, not her. Her parents suck for bringing you into it. They could have just been proud of their daughter without comparing her to anyone. Your parents suck for not defending you and for wanting you to take insults quietly. Yeah. You suck for embarrassing your cousin for what her parents did. You suck the least out of the three since you're only defending yourself, but the way you did it wasn't good. You could have just compared the schools instead. Yeah. If you recall correctly, your SAT language scores were wildly high, but your SAT math scores were pretty average. Just pulls up the multiple intelligence theory, man. I wonder if I can find my practice SAT and have my scores. Actually, I think I do know where it is. Hang on. This is so important to me right now, actually. Hang on, I'll be right back.
So, chat, how's it hanging?
Yeah, chat, how's it going? But yeah, I don't know. I found, like, the test itself, but I couldn't find my scores. It normally was connected, but I don't know what happened to it. Sad days. I know I did pretty well overall, though. Like, I remember being the higher percentiles across the board, but... shrugs. I can't prove it anymore, so whatever. Idea, apologize to cousin to find some way to tell both sets of parents to off with their petty BS getting in the way of y'all's ability to form a healthy relationship. Yeah. You can't remember yours worth a damn, but you couldn't have cared less about those stupid tests. Yeah, that's fair. I can guarantee you the main reason I remember is because I just happened to keep it and just kind of looked at it whenever I came across it and it's like, oh yeah, my PSAT. It's not that I ever really actually cared, but, you know. Man, I wish I was able to find where I ranked, because that would have been funny. Okay, wait, this seems fun. Am I the ass for asking that my boyfriend pay for a replacement cheesecake? So I, 20 female, have been dating Jacob, 26 male, for about 2 years. That means you are 18. What business does a 24-year-old have to do with dating an 18-year-old? Gonna gloss over that for now. We met through my older brother at a New Year's Eve party. We lived together for the last 6 months, and everything has been great except for his habit of eating my snacks, particularly the sweets I buy. I really didn't mind it because I don't have a huge sweet tooth like he does, and I don't buy them all the time, so him snagging a few cookies wasn't a big deal. It occasionally did annoy me when he would sometimes beat me to eating it, but he apologized for it. However, my favorite dessert is cheesecake, and I get a particular one from an expensive bakery that I don't get very often due to how pricey it was. So when I got to buy it Saturday, I was excited and popped it in the fridge for me to eat after work and dinner. I figured Jacob wouldn't eat it because he knows how much I like it, or if he wanted a slice, he'd wait for me to go home and ask me about it. Boy, was I wrong. When I got home from a job and ate my ready-made meal, I looked into the fridge for the cheesecake, only to find more than half of it gone. Damn. It was astonishing how much she ate, and I was pissed because I'd been waiting all day to eat it. Jacob was in our bedroom playing video games, so I walked into with the cheesecake box, asking why the hell he ate more than half of the damn thing without telling me. Divorce. Oh boy. Unless it looks like he ate it with his hands, which disgusted me. Ew. Jacob started that he didn't think I would mind since I don't eat sweets a lot anyways, and I usually share with him anyways. I pointed out that cheesecake is one of my favorite, and I technically don't share, he just takes my snacks without asking. This developed into an argumentative back and forth, which I eventually asked that he pay for a replacement. Jacob refused, saying it was too expensive and I was taking things too far. If it's too expensive, ask for permission. I persisted telling him it's not that much of a big deal to replace and I would give him money to do it. Well, okay, so now you're not even asking for him to pay for it. You're just asking him to go out of his way to get it. Like, bruh. And he's still saying no? Jacob eventually left for his mom's place because I was unreasonable and demanding, and that he talked to me in the morning. Well, it's the next day, and it's been radio silence from Jacob. I hope he never comes back. I asked my friends, and some agreed that he should pay for a replacement, but others said that it was just cake, and I shouldn't demand for him to pay for something I didn't really need. It's not really about a need, it's the fact that he never asked, and he just assumes. Like... not the asshole, but I don't think the issue is the cost of the cheesecake, but rather how you two share space and food. Basically, he's not listening to you and not thinking of you. Yeah. Then getting defensive when confronted and then running to his mama to throw a temper tantrum for days, which frankly he is way too old to do. Yeah. It would just gross me out if my partner sat down and ate over half a cheesecake all at once. Like, that's at least 3,000 calories. Maybe even 5,000 depending on toppings and size, etc. Plus like 2 weeks worth of a healthy daily sugar requirement. Seems like he should feel like total shit after consuming all of that. Sweet addiction is a real thing, so is binge eating. I wonder if part of his defensiveness and immaturity around the issue is that he's suffering from some sort of eating disorder. Maybe. Yeah, asking him to replace the cost is fair. He should do that just because cheesecake is very expensive. But I don't think it'll solve the problem you two are having. It won't solve the problem, but if he had agreed to it the first time, it would have been like, yeah, okay, I understand, I fucked up, sort of gesture type of thing at the very minimum, sort of thing. Over cake. He's acting like this over cake. How does he act in actual serious matters? Yeah. This man is not mature enough to live with another person. Yeah. Ugh. I mean, by that logic, if he broke his video game system, you're off the hook. He doesn't need to play video games. Oh boy. Not that asshole, and consider whether you want to remain in a relationship with someone who repeatedly eats your food and then won't replace something you bought for yourself. He then calls you unreasonable and demanding. Yeah, that's... Not that asshole. If the cost of a cheesecake is all you lost to learning what sort of person he really is, consider it cheap tuition and move on. For fuck's sake, you even offered to give him money to get the replacement cheesecake. That's what I was saying. Stop and think about that for a minute or two. Jeez. God. Not the asshole. It's not really about the cake. It's about how he's treating you. Yep. He takes things that you haven't given and expects you to be okay with it. Probably a good time for an adjustment in this relationship. Yep. Oof. Messy. Messy, messy, messy. There is another one. Yeah. Am I the asshole for laughing at how my friend used her inheritance? This will be interesting. Blip, blip, blip. I'm gonna have zoom in on Shu. Look at him in all scory. Anyways, I decided to post this with the help of my husband, who's unsure if my behavior was over the line. Here's what he thought was important for the sake of the story. My friend of about 17 years, Delilah, 37 female, had a problematic childhood. She barely went to school because her only parent was addicted to substances among many other problems. That's fun. I don't know how she slipped through the system for so long, but she was pretty much a lost cause by high school because of how little discipline she had. Bites OP for being entitled and horrible, oh boy. At 23, her dad died, and due to the matter of death, Delilah won a somewhat large sum of money. Messy. Once she got that money, Delilah chose to go to a community college. I guess she learned to love learning and had so many interests she never knew about that she went to several schools in most of her 20s and came out with several degrees. That's cool. So in my view, I've held my tongue on her wasting so much money on school. Buddy. I guess if it was my money, I want to save it or explore then to get a degree. I'll go ahead first. Okay, but you've had the privilege of going to school normally and having a normal childhood. She has 6 degrees, and to me it's just silly. You're probably just jealous she has 6 degrees. What, do you have 1 or 2? The real kicker is my husband is an engineer and makes more than she does, despite all her side jobs and projects. Yeah, he has a focused career. She has side jobs and projects. That's... no shit. Well, we were visiting her and she mentioned how she wanted to study history and maybe take a class or two online for the fun of it. I laughed and asked if any of her inheritance was even still left. Bruh. She said that shouldn't be my concern. I admitted it was ridiculous. She could have even bought a nice house with that money instead of blowing it on degrees that she doesn't even use. She told me all her degrees served a purpose. She loves what she does now and loves learning because she was deprived of it as a child. She told me she wasn't going to defend herself to someone who did not grow in a similar situation. Yeah. My husband told her to calm down? Buddy. After is now awkward, I'm not sure if I need to apologize or not. Yeah, you need to fucking apologize, but you need to realize how you fucked up first, too. Jesus. You're the asshole. You sound incredibly jealous. I wonder if all this hate and jealousy is stemming from the fact that you didn't get to attend school after high school. You said your husband makes more money than her and not you. So my question is, are you making more money than her? It doesn't matter if she spends her money on drugs or spending it on nothing but shoes and electronics, because guess what? It's her money and she can do as she pleases with it. Yes, preach. Also, she's a literal icon to me. I haven't been doing well in school much. Better than her by how you explained it. So Delilah, also my name but without the H, is giving me hope that I can still try and make it into school in my dream career. That's cute. Oh my goodness, you're the asshole. I've always thought if I won the lottery, I would become a professional student and study everything I could. Just so lucky, and there's nothing wrong with never stopping learning. Yeah. Buddy. You're the asshole, like she said, how she spends her money is not of your concern. Feel how you want, but keep it to yourself. Yeah. Also, why feel the need to point out that your husband makes more money than her? Does that matter? Yeah, like, are you trying to get in Delilah's pants or something? Like, buddy. near the asshole. I guess if it was my money, it's not. To me, it's just silly. Who cares? She loves what she does now and loves learning because she was deprived of it as a child. Fucking A. Get off her jock. Yeah, Delilah should drop OP like a fucking rock after that. Yeah, for real. You're the asshole. She was put in a fortunate financial position to do what she wanted to do and enjoy herself. Her finances are not your concern. Yeah, like, bruh. Yikes. Major yikes. Am I the asshole for laughing when someone said they wouldn't want to have kids in a Western country because they might end up like me? I, 19 female, and my friend D, 19 female, are both international students doing the same course. We're currently in the same team for a group project. I'm German Indian, and D is Singaporean Indian. I speak German, Hindi, and English. D speaks Tamil and English. English is the only language we both share. Alright. One of our group mates asked us why we both speak in English to each other when we're both Indian. He said that this loss of language and culture is the main reason why he's never going to get married and have kids outside of his home country. That it makes him sad to see people like me and Dee, who are raised in the West, lose their culture. Like, I'm pretty sure India has more than one language, right? I laughed because it was funny and I couldn't stop myself in time. Yeah, that's fair. He asked me why I laughed, and I explained to him that there's more than one Indian language. Yeah, okay, that's what I thought. It was awkward after that, and he seemed a bit embarrassed. He told me I could have been nicer about it. You could have also not said what you said. D kinda agrees, but she's worried that it might be difficult to get her project done if he's unhappy. T asked me to apologize for laughing at him, even though she agrees he was condescending. I mean, yeah, I think D has a point. Like, at least be kind enough until the project is done, okay? I don't know, man. So a guy insulted you in an ignorant way and you laughed. Sounds like this guy will make it hard to get the project done regardless. I would not apologize, not the asshole. Yeah, there is that. Seriously, don't apologize. If he says you were rude, remind him of how rude what he said was. And that while you both have probably used unprofessional tones or cadences, he's the one who made a negative judgment about your life while you only presented a fact. Yeah. Not the asshole, he owes you and your friend an apology for starting this. Yeah, real. Wild. As a fellow Indian, not the asshole, I live in India and don't speak any of the South Indian languages. Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam. I definitely butchered that one. Kannada, etc. And I barely speak Hindi. I'd say I'm above average at English, though, and I've only ever lived in the country. Oh, huh, that's interesting. To sum up, location is irrelevant. Upbringing and education is most important. And people should mind their own business, especially if they're not educated themselves on what they're talking about, like in the case of your friend. Yes. So not apologize if he wants to keep the peace, he can. Also true. Yeah. I see where D is coming from, but you shouldn't have to placate a stranger based on their assumptions about your background biting them ass. Yeah, yeah. Some people just, I don't know. Some people just, that's it. That's a thought. I don't feel like listening to this song.
Oh.
を愛して何が悪いの嫉妬でしょうか痛いだとか変わってるとか届きませんね。
Oh boy, more cheesecake. Am I the asshole for throwing a tantrum at my mother for cutting into a cake I baked into for the family? Baked into? I think that might have been extra. I, female 17, baked a cheesecake for my family to share, and I was letting it cool down when my mother cut herself a slice. It was still hot, so it crumbled in on itself. I was really upset because I had worked super hard to make it and I was hoping to take photos. Also, the cheesecake doesn't taste right when hot. Yeah, exactly. It's a cheesecake. So I yelled at her, why would she do that? Especially since I already told her that the cheesecake needed to cool for 8 hours. Yeah. She said that since she paid for the ingredients and pays the bills that she let me use the oven, I have no right to complain about it. Okay, but like the cheesecake isn't even good hot! It wasn't done! Also, if it's for the family, why does it matter if it tastes better when it's cool? Because that's the process. It's her choice as a person that wants to eat it, but it wasn't ready. And she grounded me for being disrespectful and a selfish bitch. Well, I guess someone's not getting cake ever again. My brother is on her side and says I need to get over it. Why do I care so much over a cake? Who cares? We all ate it anyway. Isn't that what you wanted? Because it's her labor, and it wasn't ready, and it was cut into. Like, buddy. Does the mom understand how cheesecake works at all? Probably not. Yeah, definitely not the asshole, sweetie. Jesus. Selfish bitch. This alone kind of makes your mom the asshole. No mother should call her child this for trying to kindly bake something for the family to share. Yeah. Isn't it normal for stuff like that to slip out when you're mad, even for parents? You shouldn't call your child a bitch. Doesn't matter if you're mad at them. Like, unless everyone is fully, firmly adults, fine, call your 26-year-old problem child a bitch, but not when they're 17 and just wanted you to understand how the fuck cheesecake works. Oh wait, that's OP that said that. Oh no, OP, that is not normal. Are you okay, OP? I forget what I made, but this reminds me of when her mom was about to drown something in hot sauce without trying it first, and that became a whole thing. Yeah, I remember that. God. No. Oops. Second, why not say I feel like you're acting ungrateful because of X, Y, and Z instead of jumping immediately to selfish bitch? Sure, the mom put money into it, but OP put in hours of effort trying to do something nice. Yeah. Ugh. Poor OP. Not the asshole. Excuse you for wanting to prepare the cheesecake properly and allow it to cool as it's supposed to. Does your mom have so little patience and so little respect for the effort you went through to make it, now that she couldn't wait until it was ready? I don't think she would die from not having not finished cheesecake at the exact moment. Imagine if she ate a not fully cooked chicken or some other meat dish just because she wanted it right then. Yeah. She's done that before, where she's tasted things before they're done and gone and mad at me for wasting ingredients, making shit food, or not cooking it right. But it wasn't ready yet. Oh my god. If I could just adopt random people on the internet, I would definitely take OP, because like, fuck, that's... Some people should not be parents, and OP's parents should not be parents. Yikes. Hello. Am I the asshole for not letting my son play with his friend after the friend's mom said my sister will go to hell? Tentative, not the asshole, but let's see what's here. I, 37 female, am a mom to 3 boys. My middle son, Leo, 10 male, is in 4th grade, and his best friend's family is very religious. Oh boy. Leo often spends time at his friend's house, and I know the friend's mom has talked to him about religion before. Not a friend's mother's place to do, but carry on. She even took him to church along with his friend a few times. Leo had some interesting questions after that. That's fair. I didn't think any of this was a problem, because I have told my boys that a lot of people believe different things, and it's important to make sure you have all the facts before deciding whether to believe something. Valid. I've had some bad experiences with religion, but I haven't shared this with my son. Yeah, I'd rather he gets an unbiased view from me. Also fair. Anyways, he's a bright kid and understands this, so I don't mind him being exposed to other people's religious ideas. That's fair. Pretty based of you. My sister passed away suddenly a few months back, and we attended her funeral last week. It was tough. Yeah. Yesterday, Leo was at his friend's house for dinner, and he seemed upset when he came home. I asked him what happened. He said his friend's mom had said that his aunt would have gone to hell because she didn't believe in God. He seemed worried, and I reassured him that it's not true. I said that if God does happen to exist, I'm sure he wouldn't send my sister to hell because she was a lovely person. This made sense to him, so he let it go. But I was absolutely furious, and I told him that I didn't want him to go to his friend's house ever again. He got really mad and said I was overreacting, and I can't stop him from being friends with his friends just because his mom is stupid. I said you'll still see your friend in school, but I don't want you ever to see his mom again. Now that the rage has cooled though, I wonder if I'm being unfair to my son. Am I that asshole? I don't think so. Like, as long as you're fine with her son, like, still coming over to your place and they can still hang out, cool. But I don't blame you for, like, keeping your son away from that mom because you. Bruh, even our mom's Mormon friends looking after us took care to avoid talking about religion unless it was expressly relevant and we shared a freaking chapel. Yeah. Yeah. Let's see what the people have to say, though. Comments are kind of wild. Some saying Opie should not ban herself from going to Crazy Town. Rather speak to the circus conductor. That won't help or change anything. It will fuel the crazy fire. Try reasoning with the crazy person, see how that goes. Some say she's punishing her son because of the circus conductor, but that's not punishing him. Let's assume it is. Then what's the alternative? She'd be a responsible parent to knowingly allow such a crazy woman to be alone with her son, let alone letting him go to her house unsupervised. Yeah. That's not okay. The kids can hang out at school and at OP's house. OP would be an asshole if she banned the friendship, but that's not the case. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, like, you don't say that shit to a 10-year-old. You really don't. Like, especially when the kid's not even your kid, you know? Like, you shouldn't say it to your kid, but, like, especially not someone else's kid, you know? She should have already stamped this out when her son was taken to church. And almost certainly a hateful church given the mom's attitude toward OP's deceased sister. Yeah. The kids can hang out at a park, at a school, or at a park, not a crazy person's home. Yep. You having fun there, Peachy? You love this song? I can tell. Trust me, I can tell. Okay, we have a wedding one after this one. Am I the asshole for telling my boyfriend's sister about his plans to smear cake into her face at her birthday party? Why would you do that? It was my 24 female boyfriend, 24 male sister's 27th birthday this past weekend. My boyfriend told me about the plan he made with his brother, 29 male I think, to push their sister's face into the birthday cake during the cake cutting. I asked him if that was a tradition in their family, and he said no. They just wanted to screw with her in a fun way on her birthday. So you put your finger in the frosting and then boop her on the nose. You don't stuff her face in the cake. I told him that he should at least tell his sister they were going to do it, and he said there would be no fun in it if she would not even agree. Because it's not fun. I kept telling him to not do it then, but he told me it would be fine. It would not be fine if you think she's not gonna like it. I decided to tell my boyfriend's sister about it ahead of time so that she could duck if she needed to or something. She told me thanks for letting her know. Anyways, my boyfriend and I went to her party yesterday, and my boyfriend and his brother were right next to their sister during the cake cutting. I saw their hands still, like, behind her head, and she was bending down to blow out the candles. Now, Nara is like she had eyes on the back of her head or something. She quickly got back up and maneuvered, and I guess somehow she pushed the older brother, the 29 male's face, into the cake after he seemed to try to do it to her. It was pretty funny at the time since everyone, but my boyfriend and his brother were laughing. Yeah, I know. They got what they deserved, frankly. Anyways, before we left the party, my boyfriend asked me if I tipped his sister off because before the cake cutting, I could read. And I admitted it and told him I had to since it would be wrong to humiliate her on her birthday without her consent. My boyfriend was a bit upset for a bit and blah blah blah. But he said he wasn't that upset since his sister ended up pushing their older brother's face on the cake instead and not his. I mean, fair. I guess he was just in it for someone's face to go on the cake. He didn't care whose. but no, not the asshole, especially since your boyfriend isn't that, annoyed. I do agree with Storm Mickey here, though. Just remember how he thinks it was a funny idea if you ever marry him. You'll be wearing your wedding cake as a joke. Yeah. It was incredibly clear that to anyone who attempted a cake smash with me at my wedding would be escorted out and billed. If it was the groom, I tossed in divorce papers. I'm being a touch factitious? But I personally really hate public humiliation jokes. Yeah. Especially when I've spent time and effort on my makeup and clothes. I probably would have reflexively cried, so I figured better to make my feelings known. Yeah, good. Good call. I don't know. I think it's really funny that the older brother got his face in the cake and the boyfriend was okay with that. Facetious? Probably. I don't know. Wild. Wild, wild, wild. At least that one seemed to have a happy end, though. Would have loved to see the sister absolutely 180 that situation, little brother. Yeah. Yeah, that's pretty iconic. I'm a little worried about this one, though. Am I the asshole for making fun of my brother-in-law's resting bitch face at my wedding? I, 30 female, got married to the love of my life late last month. My husband, 30 male, has a younger brother, 28 male, who is very, very kind and sweet, and he's got a bit of a shy puppy demeanor to him, which is really endearing. The only problem is that my brother-in-law has a rather angry resting bitch face. His eyebrows are always furrowed, even when he's smiling, and his neutral face has him looking pissed off and unapproachable. During the wedding reception, I was sitting at the table with my husband and his and my family members. My brother-in-law was sitting across from me. He was just sitting there, looking angry as fuck as usual. But I know that's just his normal expression. I thought to myself that the other guests may be kind of scared by his expression, and so I cheerfully told my brother-in-law to turn that frown upside down. My brother-in-law started smiling and he laughed, but then he fell right back into his resting bitch face. So I reached across the table and I said, "Come on now." I used my index fingers to force the corners of his mouth upwards. My brother-in-law sort of freaked out and he squirmed to push himself away from me. Yeah, because you shouldn't touch people without permission. Wild concept, I know. Later that night, while my husband and I were in bed together, after the first day of officially being a married couple, my husband brought up the little thing I tried to do with my brother-in-law's mouth. He let me know that that was kind of weird, and it made him and to his brother really uncomfortable. I told my husband that was all just a joke and it was nothing serious, but my husband got a little... got a bit incensed, and he bluntly told me, 1. Don't touch my brother. 2. That's just how he always looks, and there's nothing wrong with that. And 3. Don't touch my brother. Yeah. That shut me up real quick. As it should. Am I the asshole? I still feel as though it was all just a joke that everybody's overreacting about. It seems like the point went right over your head. Yikes. You're the asshole, don't touch people without consent. You made a comment to which he laughed. So there you demonstrated to the other guests at the table that he wasn't scary. Now leave him alone. Yep. And do not call it a joke because no one was laughing at to you ride handling your brother-in-law's mouth. Yeah. Especially don't touch their mouths. Ew, I would be so disgusted if someone put their fingers or in my lips. Yeah. Ugh. Yeah, we got it. That's fucked up. Like, I thought this was gonna be worse. Like, a whole, like, oh, I don't know, make fun of him for having resting bitch face at all sort of thing. Like, that's what I was expecting this to go. But they seem to be, like, kind of okay with that. But then just this instead? Ugh. Messy, messy, messy. Let's refresh the page, see if anything else comes up up top. Nope. So far seems to be in the same order. Alright, I didn't read this one. Am I the asshole for asking my husband to not come to my prenatal appointment? Preemptively, no, but this seems to be a long post, so who knows where this goes. Certainly not I. Prior to my 4th prenatal appointment, my husband and I got into a fight. The fight occurred while I was describing a situation at work and got frustrated and emotional while explaining myself. My husband was questioning and challenging my interpretation of it, and I felt like he was being argumentative. So I said, "You wouldn't understand. You don't have to work with gossips and judgmental people. He works from home and has limited in-person interaction with other people for his job." I started crying out of frustration. He got angry and said I was blowing up over nothing. "Then why are you getting angry?" He then went silent and didn't speak to me for the rest of the day. But she's... okay. His conflict management style is the silent treatment. That's not conflict management, that's ignoring the problem. Often for days, sometimes for 1 to 2 weeks at a time. That's... bloody. Anticipating this, I told him that if we were not on speaking terms at the time of my prenatal appointment, that I do not feel comfortable with him coming, and that I would get ultrasound images and provide a summary of the appointment for him. Fair. I told this to him in words and by text. Well, he showed up to my prenatal appointment and forced himself in. Ew. I was too humiliated to make a scene, but quietly said, "What the fuck are you doing here?" Afterwards, he said, "It's our baby, so it's our appointment. It's her pregnancy. You fuck off and stay at home." And I said, "Actually, I'm the patient and it's my appointment and you're there as a visitor." Yeah, facts. I told him I felt violated and betrayed. Truly, I feel bullied by his behavior and would like an apology. I wanted him to be there and he has come to most of my other appointments. But I didn't feel comfortable with him being there if he was engaging in the silent treatment and aggression. He maintains that he has every right to be at my doctor's appointments whether I'm okay with it or not. Unless she is sick and dying, no you don't. But even then, if she's sick and dying, no you don't. Like, buddy. Are you carrying the baby, sir? you're right. Editing to add a big thank you to everyone who has commented and shared their story of any similar experiences, positive or negative. I didn't expect the volume and polarity of responses this post has received, and running through every comment and taking your thoughts to heart, thank you. Second edit, I'm overwhelmed by the number of comments. I thought this post would fly under the radar. Respond to some questions / clarifications to provide updates. My husband asked to speak with me this evening, and we had a calm and productive talk. That's good. This is a quick turnaround time for him. He clarified that he did overreact and blow up over my crying due to him misunderstanding something I said, and that he did think my being upset about work was valid. Okay, that's good. I did not anticipate the amount of responses regarding my mention of the silent treatment. I now wish I didn't mention in this particular post, though appreciate all your advice, especially the heartfelt and enlightening responses from those of you who suffered under a parent or partner, and those of you who have used the silent treatment yourselves. There have been a handful of instances of the silent treatment that were 1 to 3 weeks long. Most other instances were a few days. I knew the silent treatment was wrong. It makes me feel terrible, and I know it can be abusive when used to manipulate or punish. I don't recall him using the silent treatment like that until the last year, so this oddly was an issue earlier in our relationship. Even though he describes it as a long-term behavior for him, that was normal growing up in his family. I spoke tonight about how damaging it was and my fear of his doing it again in front of or to our kid. He agreed it was unacceptable and has to change. I also have some conflict responses of my own that I like to work on. Growth? Hello? My husband does individual therapy and has so for some time. I do not currently plan on doing couples therapy again as I do not find it very productive, rather sometimes counterproductive. It will continue individual therapy. Fair enough. For those asking why did I have a baby with this man, I have provided one glimpse into our relationship, and though it is an ugly one, it's just a glimpse. True. I'm happy, not miserable, the majority of the time. That's good. I think my am I the asshole question of the prenatal appointment is debatable, but agree that the silent treatment is awful and unacceptable behavior even if it's not done maliciously. I'm pregnant now with a very wanted baby and will have worked very hard on ensuring a loving, safe, and healthy environment to provide healthy environment for baby. There we go. No matter what that requires of myself or my husband. There we go. But yeah, good on them for getting a lot of growth. That definitely sounded like a lot worse with this glimpse, but yeah, they're working to, they understand now, both of them, the mistakes and have corrected them. So you know what? Good for them. Like, generally good for them. Am I the asshole for making my mom cry? Depends. Oh boy, they have been cleared, not the asshole. Let's see. I think I might read only one or two more posts and then call it a night, because I'm inky. Yeah. Hi, I'm female 19, have been interpreting / translating for my older deaf sister, 26 female, as long as I can remember. My sister lost all her hearing at the age of 3. My parents are not fluent in American Sign Language, so they only use home signs, made-up signs including pointing. I'm the youngest of 7, and the one who knows the most ASL. Because of this, I have been interpreting / translating for my sister to my parents, sometimes older siblings, etc. Growing up, I'd always get irritated when parents / siblings would make me interpret. I've increasingly gotten more irritated with them over the years. Not my deaf sister, it's not her fault. Yeah. My older siblings have made a small effort into learning more ASL. My parents, on the other hand, have not. That's nice. Yesterday, my deaf sister vented to me after struggling to understand what her mom was trying to tell her. This wasn't the first time, but for some reason it made me angry, unlike the other times where I was just frustrated. I approached my mom and told her what my sister had said. My mom replied that she can't remember signs because of her age. She's 50. You can definitely learn a language at that age. I told her that she had 23 years to learn ASL, but didn't make an effort to. Yup. My mom then said it wasn't her fault because there are not many resources to learn ASL for Spanish speakers. My parents know very little English. That is messy. I brought up how I've translated in written format English videos teaching ASL to Spanish, but she never utilized my papers. I then told her that she can't even sign what's your favorite color, and that she was never there for my sister when traumatic things were happening. Oof. This is when my mom started to cry and asked why I was blaming her. I did not comfort her. I just left to my room. I love my parents and my deaf sister does too, but it can get hard sometimes. We have our good days and bad days, and I am honestly tired. I think this is why I snapped. After the argument, I felt bad. My parents are immigrants. They never finished elementary school. Maybe that is why they couldn't learn ASL. I've never gotten into a big argument like that with my mom and have not apologized. I mean, it's messy. It's messy. This is an edit. I redownloaded Reddit for this and was not expecting a lot of replies. Thank you to those who did reply. I have never explained my and my sister's situation to anyone. I'm getting emotional reading these replies because it feels like my frustrations are valid. My sister's experiences are getting recognized slash seen. That's good. I have always blamed myself for getting irritated when having to interpret for my sister. I never thought much of it when I was younger. I thought it was normal. When I took ASL classes during high school, I realized that my sister herself was not fluent in ASL because she grew up around hearing people who did not know how to communicate with her in ASL. She has very few deaf friends. Sometimes it feels like I'm older than her because of the way she was raised. My sister was born hearing, but lost all of it at the age of 3 because of meningitis. She first went to an all-deaf school, but eventually got mainstream into an all-hearing public school. It is true, like some of you say, she feels isolated sometimes. My older siblings are making an effort to learn ASL more than I have seen them do before. My sister is the kindest person I know and is helping them along the way. She has accepted the fact that my parents will never learn ASL and still loves them. She tells me that in the deaf community, it is normalized. As someone mentioned before, 70% of deaf children have parents who do not know sign language. It is sad, but it is the truth. Currently, my mom is giving me the silent treatment. I have told my parents to learn ASL numerous times throughout my life. All they do is get mad or make me feel bad, but I have never made her cry before. I sympathize with my parents because they never received proper education. All they did was work since they were little. I don't think that validates why they didn't learn ASL. That is why I argued with her. Trying to do my best to be there for my sister and will continue to do so. Yeah, that's fair. That is definitely messy, though. And not the asshole crocodile tears from mom. How dare you make me feel guilty about something I very much should feel guilty about. Yeah. She offloaded this task, her task, to you, and is using the crying move to keep things status quo. The one who should be crying is your sister, whose own fucking mom won't even work to communicate with her. Yeah. They managed to move across national frontiers, have several kids, have lived and careers in a new society and all the rest. And they apparently can't learn the basics of sign language in over 20 years because they're immigrants. OP's mom's problem is not her immigrant status. It's because she didn't think communicating with her daughter was worth her time. Yeah. Ugh. Messy, messy, messy. Yeah, I've read the first few sentences and know all I need to. You're not the asshole. Yeah, that's fair. Bruh. Like, I can imagine it being hard to find the resources, but, like, after your one of your children provides you the resources to learn ASL, at least basic ASL from Spanish, like, you should have done it. Messy. I'm gonna try to find one more to read and then we'll be done. Trying to find a good one to end on. Yeah. 3 hours ago. Okay. Am I the asshole for reminding my brother that it's his fault he didn't get to raise my niece? He went to prison for identity theft and forgery when my niece, now 18, was only 7 years old. Yeah, okay. I raised her from the point. Now that he is out, he has visited us a few times. The first visit was a little bit awkward, fair. I had asked my niece if she is ready and wants to see him, and she said yes to both, but it was still a little weird. On the second one, it was better. The third visit, he found out that I had allowed her to do boxing since she was 10, and that she's still taking classes with a personal trainer every week. My brother got really upset about it. He then said girls shouldn't do boxing and that I had failed as an uncle. And as I was just standing there, stunned for a moment, then I asked, should I have committed forgery and gone and sent to prison like you instead? It's your fault that you weren't around to make the choices. In hindsight, I realized it was kind of a dick move for me to say that to someone who just got out not too long ago, but I was just so pissed at the moment. My mother also called me later that night to say I didn't have to throw that in his face that way. Should I have just held my tongue? I'm not... For the sake of peace, maybe you should have held your tongue, but at the same time, I don't know, you reap what you sow sort of thing, you know? Like, kind of had that coming. Not the asshole. He opted not to be there for her, and it doesn't seem like he tried to do any parenting from behind bars. True. If he's upset about the past, it's his way of deflecting the blame, and maybe he needed that reminder from you, as harsh as it may have felt. Yeah. Yeah. You hit him with a 2x4, but he had it coming. Yeah. I agree with that one. OP's brother deserved it only because of the lack of gratitude for the sacrifices OP made to raise his niece instead of sending her into the system, but also for the extremely sexist comments that girls shouldn't box. This girl sounds like a total badass who could probably kick her dad's ass. Yeah. I think he did the right thing. He shouldn't assume that women shouldn't be in self-defense classes. By the way, awesome job raising her. Someone stepped into my life into a parent role and I'll always be grateful. Aww. Yeah. Well, that's an exciting one to end on, I guess. Exciting. I really did not do that much in this drawing today. Oh well. That's fine. Let's see. I think I'm going to raid Hiragi Yu. Because I can. Hiragi Yu is currently playing Baten Kaito's Eternal Wings in the Lost Ocean. Apparently, it's their favorite video game of all time that got remastered. So, yeah. That's gonna be the plan. Let me... blah, blah, blah. This one. Hehe. I know what I'm doing, kind of. There you go. Yeah, I'll be reading Hiragi Yu. I hope you guys enjoyed watching. And it was a little different than usual. Well, that game, you remember you being excited about it ages ago? Fair enough. I mean, it is their favorite game, so it makes sense. Hiragi's U raid settings do not allow you to raid at this time. Really? Wait, really? Let me try again. Just in case. Okay, I guess I can't read Hiragi Yu, actually. Interesting. Well, so much for that plan. I don't... wild. Maybe Hiragi Yu has it set to, like, mutuals only. That might be it. Okay, well, there goes that plan. Damn. You'd guess that's relatively recent, but when you rated them, unless you don't remember how long ago that was actually. I've rated Hiragi Yu in the past. I think it's because they're just back from their vacation, that could be part of it. Or otherwise, they had other reasons that they found it necessary to change their settings. I don't normally have the chance to raid, you, so... don't know who to read instead. That link threw me off. It's like, oh yeah, Hiragi Yu. No brainer, but apparently not. Damn. I think I just won't read anyone then. you guys could disperse to Hiragi Yu on their own. Here. There you go. Indirectly, raid Hiragi Yu. Go click that link. Get out of here, you scoundrels. I'll be back Thursday with Peachy unless something goofy happens for more diddly rompus. Yeah. Next week, there won't be a Monday stream. We'll be watching Devilman Crybaby. So that's also exciting. But, yeah, otherwise, toodaloo. Go bug you because you can. I don't know. Bye.